And it's a sick new band, and they've got loads of new shit coming up. So watch
out, mate. That's what I'm saying.
Rock and roll.
Check
that out. I tell you, cannot wait to check it out. Right, could you give us three words to describe your style?
Oh, she likes the hard questions, doesn't she?
I'm gonna go in quick with Gypsy Chav Punk.
Ooh.
Or Punk Chav Gypsy.
I don't back that up.
Well, I was speaking for myself. Are you from Gypsy heritage?
Our great granddad, we think, must have been a Gypsy settler in the East End. Because all the geezers that were pulling the barges with the big shire horses back then pretty much were. So our family, the roots are Gypsy. And we've got family members in Australia telling us so as well. So.
Oh, I've got family members in Australia.
Gorgy bread, though.
I'm still trying to think of three words. I think
come back.
So, ravers.
Oh God, you
rave chic.
Yeah, love that. Yeah, absolutely love it, girls. Right, what I'm going to do, I'm going to play another track, and I think this probably will lead nicely from what you were just talking about before. I'm going to go with Gypsy Boy.
Wait, 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 wait.
Okay, so I think the version you're going to drop, yes, the version you're going to drop is the Ed Cox Clowncore remix.
Yes. Oh, sorry.
Live for Lan's very own. Yeah, big up. So she's girlfriend's locked in. Boss lady, love ya.
Big up yourself.
Yeah, so this track was a remix of an original. We did pretty much our first music video, I think.
It was our first music video.
And yeah, we got Enjoy Chaos to mess it up a bit for the YouTube video, the remix that is Ed Cox's version, which is actually 240 BPM, which sounds ridiculous fast. But you know, you can dance on the half time, and there's also a bit of 3/4 in there, so you get a bit like da 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 going on.
I really like this. I really like this.
Yeah.
Is it because you're a Cockney?
Yeah. Well, I don't know. I just love it. I'm really, really so.
I'm surprised you think this one. Here it is. 240 BPM.
That's right.
This is the remix.
Oh, so we got a gig at this festival through a good old man called Phil. 2 hours in a cab and we just arrived. Free tickets and he paid the bill.
Here we go.
110 only not, but we'll never worry in a hurry when we left the flat. Stage was small, didn't care at all, cause we were being paid in cash. We did the gig and it went down well, couldn't wait to have a drink. So we went backstage with this gypsy band and they fancied us. We think,
oi, oi.
Gypsy band had a sleep and we had a laugh. 2 days later couldn't find one another till the death of the aftermath. I felt congratulated with a boy called Ray till the sun went down both days. Can't remember when I lost my sister till the time it was all the hate.
Wait for the 3/4.
All the rest it was history. We loved each other in our hearts. Wanna say it was misery.
Being off your head at a festival.
I fell in love with a gypsy boy. They stole my virgin lady. I went out with a gypsy girl and she taught me how to kiss.
True story.
I fell in love with a gypsy boy. They stole my virgin lady. I went out with a gypsy girl and she taught me how to kiss.
In case you're wondering what a banjo lady is, it's a cross between a ukulele and a banjo.
Yeah.
Techers.
I was wondering what that was.
See one another, but could hear our voice.
I thought it was
2 days later, we wasn't there. Didn't care about the gypsies and sound. Off we went, we started in a house to find a band. And the hours that we lost, couldn't find a band or a bass made man. But a girl that couldn't give a toss. Oi, oi, oi.
Massive shout out to Minx.
She locked in.
Oh, yeah, it's on the Facebook.
Had a ring through and there's more tamarind round her neck. Long red hair, was pretty with a fan, and a panty, our banjo lady back. We searched all day in the sun, there was cover, there was nowhere to be seen. Must have been baby, who stole my banjo lady
nearly stole my badgerly. I went out with a gypsy girl and she told me how to gaily.
You're listening to the best in Britain show with DJ Sweet Lee.
Yeah, that track's heavy.
Aww.
Now I understand that about the BPM, how, because it did go fast, didn't it?
It did go fast.
And then it's got like the same 3/4.
It doesn't feel like it's manic fast.
No, I could dance to that easy.
Skilled
techers of Ed Coxey. He brings it in, he throws it out there too fast for you, but you don't even know.
Yeah, no, he's amazing. Actually amazing, isn't he?
Yeah.
Now, what's it like working together, two sisters?
Well, we argue quite a lot, I'm not going to lie. you know, like cat and dog, really. But my mum thinks we were a married couple in a previous life.
Really?
Yeah, like husband and wife,
yeah.
Bickering. Yeah.
Not in a weird way.
No,
obviously. You know, just in a kind of like that sort of relationship way, you know, just friendly. But
I've only knocked her out 10 times in a life.
How we do it is we have jobs. So, for example, she's a stylist. She has the final say on the looks.
Wow, so amazing job in styling. I was going to say, you
go on,
too.
Smoke, go on.
I'll tell you, you look amazing, you too.
Thank you. And I tend to be the sort of, I have the final say as the musical director.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And she has the final say as the director for the videos.
Ah.
She's more of a visual girl in that way. And I do all the bookings and the sort of more managey stuff.
She does the admin.
As Polly says, oh, go on, you go and do the boring
I'm
stuff.
Like that.
I'm
like that when we fall out. I'm like, I'll go and like create a new video, come up with a concept for a new like outfit, and write
a couple of songs. You can email an agent about a gig. Do you know what? It's just as important. You know, the thing is, there's so many great artists out there, and they've got no idea how to sort of make it. I wouldn't say monetize it, but you know, make a living out of it
make
and
a business
push. This stuff.
It is hard.
Because it is hard, and it is a business at the end of the day. You know, it's an industry. It's the music industry. And a lot of really amazingly talented artists do struggle in that area. So I guess I'm kind of like the manager in a way, because I would like to do that more in the future. You know, manage new talent.
So if you're an up-and-coming artist at home, you need Skinny Soddy sending all the emails out.
Shut up. But no one's going to listen to me unless I've done a bit myself, you know, get a bit of experience.
So yeah, you have.
Well, exactly. Right. That's what
you're
doing.
You're very experienced.
Thank you.
You are.
But what's the biggest room you know?
The room for improvement, eh?
Who? Did you like that one? Did she get it?
No.
Oh,
she didn't get it.
What's the biggest room you know? Room for improvement.
I thought you were talking about a track, you know. I was thinking, hang on, if you sent me this track.
You give me an idea now, that's going to be the next track. That's the next single. Could do a 150 banger.
Yeah, so I'm looking forward to that.
That's the new BPM, by the way. We're on 150 now. Just shifted it up 10 BPM faster than the bass line.
Yeah, we've got Mandy Dextrous and Stibbs making us tunes.
Ooh.
That's going to be the new My Bad Sister Flex. So look out, that's going to be coming out early next year.
Before that, we've got two singles coming out with videos. One's called Warrior.
Ooh.
Where we do Warrior Pose, as in yoga, Warrior Pose. Check out the video. It's a hip-hop video with yoga in it.
Ooh,
sounds so radical.
You too good at yoga? You too good at yoga?
I've done a bit in my time. Just a little bit.
I can hold a crow pose for a few minutes, you know?
Love the old headstand into the crow pose, back into the headstand. I'm not showing off.
I'm not very good at yoga at all.
We went to India and grasped it.
It's not about showing off, though. It's not about the look. It's not about the shapes you create. It's about meditating and using those shapes to make you get into a meditative state, which I need because I really struggle.
See, I struggle with
stuff
like that badly. And
yes.
I want to really get into that.
So yoga's for you, babe. Yoga is for you. You've got the physique for it.
See, but there's all different types of yoga. And there's all different types, isn't there? There's the one where you've got, you know, the when it's very relaxing, you've got fitness yoga, there's the hot yoga where they go to the steam room. There's so many different types.
It's a bit like dance.
Tried the right one.
Exactly, it's a bit like dance music. There's so many different genres and stuff. But the main thing, just like dance music, the main thing is to make you dance, isn't it?
Yeah, exactly.
And the same for yoga, the main thing is about getting you to meditate. which is important for everyone.
See, I didn't realise that at all. I didn't realise.
That is what it's about.
Right, I've got to get back on the yoga.
You have. It's for everyone.
It is for everyone.
I don't want to hear, I've got a bad knee, I've got a shitty hip. Don't want to hear it, all right?
No excuses, all right?
I'm on it. You won't know.
I'm going to send you a photo, yeah, of me in that pose.
Please, I want you to see you in dancer's pose before the end of the week.
Right, dancer's pose, I need to look this
up. Yeah, keep your hips parallel to the floor.
Oh, that's that one, where you grab your foot, you put your hand, and you go forward.
Making it look easy.
She's showing off now. But alcohol and yoga,
I know that's not good. I know it's not
good. Wow.
That's flexibility. That is.
Now, what about the lyrics? Where does the inspiration come for your lyrics? I don't know. I mean, for example, we could speak about Keep It Down. We were recording a track one day, and our mate turns around us and goes, oh, shut the windows, close the door, turn it up. Like that, and we went, because you want to hear more? And then we were like, that's a hook.
That certainly is a hook.
It's as simple as that.
I'm going to drop that next. At least it's nice for me to that one.
Yeah, where this come from, apart from when she just told you how we got the hook, that this is, I wanted to make a tune about the amount of people that have been banging on my caravan door, start telling me to shut up with Boomtown or at Glastonbury. And I'm going, shut the window, close the door, turn it up because you want to hear more, or jog on.
Exactly what they do, isn't it?
Or when
they
want to
hear music, loud.
It gets to Monday afternoon and it turns more into shut the window, close the door, turn it off because I want to go home.
That's what it turns into sometimes.
Oh, she's got to stop smoking. Basically, don't tell us to shut up because this is what we say. The next one coming up. And if you do want to check the video out, it's online. And we're in Deptford again. Because we like Deptford, just in case you didn't know.
The bits.
Yeah, are you originally from Deptford though?
No, we're born in Barking.
We're East Londoners. This is why we're West Ham supporters.
East
really.
London connection.
Sorry, Dad.
We've been in Deptford for 10 years and we love it south of the pipe. We wouldn't go back north of the pipe.
See, I love South London.
We
as
like
well.
South of the pipe people. Relax, cheaper, and girls wear less makeup in South London.
Don't say that to Minx. She's our North London girl.
But she's always looking on point, obviously.
Oh, she's gorgeous.
No, North London's girls look on point. I'm not taking it away for you girls. You look on point. I'm just saying it's a bit more relaxed down south, you know? I'm going to give a massive shout out to DJ Emron. Hey. Hey, Stephen. Lady like Penny. Sweet Lee's in the building alongside my bad sister.
Turn it up because you want to hear more. Shut the windows and close the door.
I'm gonna take it. I'm gonna take it. I'm gonna take it. I'm gonna take it. I'm gonna take it.